Welcome back for the finale of What If Mace Windu Survived and Trained Ahsoka. Thank you for your support on the first two parts of this What If. If you haven't seen them, the links will be in the description below. The new recruits to the Rebel Alliance stood around a holo table, and with the new superweapon called a Death Star still incomplete, the Rebels had to strike soon. Bail Organa uses a secret line of transmission, and transfers a signal to every Rebel cell, requesting their presence for a full attack on the Empire. As they awaited the arrival of the Allies, Leia received another transmission from the revolutionaries on the planet of Lothal, reporting that Vader had been sent to deal with them. The Force wielders aboard knew they had to apprehend the Sith apprentice, and they hide themselves in a small freighter to try and get through the inevitable blockade. As they approach the planet, however, their attempts to hide their Force presence cannot bypass the life scanners, and their cover is blown. The ship is drawn in by an Imperial cruiser, and the Force users ignite their blades. Warding off the station troopers, Luke and Obi-Wan manage to take an Imperial shuttle, and they descend to the surface below. The group land on the grassy plains, but are quickly surrounded by an entire army. Out of one of the lines of squadrons emerged Darth Vader, and Ahsoka nearly collapsed as she sensed remnants of Anakin Skywalker. Recovering to bravely ignite her blade, along with the others, they lure the stormtroopers into a nearby hill, and the Empire are forced to split up. One by one, the stormtroopers began to fall, and Vader intervenes. Dueling Luke first, the power of the Jedi is intriguing to Vader, and if turned to the dark side, he could be a powerful ally. But Luke was no match, and as Vader was about to deal a fatal blow, Windu leapt in to block with his blade. When Vader had seen Windu, he had not believed the Jedi Master had survived the fall on Coruscant, but now in a duel, the Vapad style was one which could not be mistaken. Vader tried to use his power to hack away Windu's strikes, but his suit meant he could not keep up with Windu's unpredictable moves, and the Sith toppled to the ground. Vader wheezed as Windu pointed his lightsaber at his mask, then slashed it, unveiling a face of terror. As the battle outside fell to a standstill, Ahsoka, Obi-Wan and Luke surrounded the broken Vader, and Luke approached him against the wishes of Obi-Wan. The young Skywalker felt a connection with the machine, and Vader revealed that Luke was his son. The Jedi instructed the others to bring medical attention to his father, and Ahsoka rushes off to find a stretcher from the nearby city. As he is helped to his feet, Windu and Obi-Wan do not lose their focus, keeping their lightsabers ignited and pointing them in his direction, wary that this was a form of Sith manipulation. Once Ahsoka had returned, they re-enter the Imperial shuttle, and Windu commands Vader to tell them location of Palpatine. Eager to get rid of his suit and the torture his master had subjected him to since his fall to the dark side, he muttered to the former Jedi that Palpatine had lured the Rebels into a trap before falling out of consciousness. Ahsoka quickly relays a signal to the Rebel cells and Bail Organa, but their silence did nothing to dispel their fears. Eventually, they find the battle station, scarring the galaxy with his vulgarity, and in front of it, they were confronted with an entire fleet. With no sign of what had happened to the Rebel Alliance, Luke guided the ship into the firing line of the Imperial fleet, and they began to weave their way through. Like his father, Luke was a naturally gifted pilot, and he guided them into the hangar with little damage to their shuttle. Upon landing, Luke and Ahsoka head back to the Imperial fleet, taking TIE fighters from the hangar, in their bid to rescue the Rebels, leaving Obi-Wan and Windu to tackle Palpatine. The Sith Lord is calmly seated atop his throne, and turned from observing the fleet to facing Obi-Wan and Windu. Looking at Windu, Palpatine was somewhat impressed at how he had survived his injuries, but this time, he would ensure there was no survival. The Sith Lord sent a massive wave of Sith lightning, and Obi-Wan is sent back into a wall, whilst Windu defended from the attack and pushed forwards. Walking slowly to Palpatine, the Sith Lord realised that Windu had not lost any of his Force abilities, and ignites his blades. Breaking the glass behind him, Palpatine depressurizes the room, and they hang on to nearby pillars, until Palpatine is sent flying into space by a Force push from Obi-Wan and Windu. Watching Palpatine's body explode in a cloud of black smoke, they stagger back to the hangar, and to their relief, the Rebels have been rescued. Reconvening on Bail Organa's ship, Windu had finally redeemed himself for his initial failure to defeat the Sith. That is it for What If Mace Windu Survived and Trained Ahsoka. If you enjoyed this What If, please like this video, turn on that notification bell, subscribe to this channel, and my other channel What If Films for more What Ifs. And as always, leave a comment on what If you'd like to see next, and how I can improve my videos. Thank you all very much for watching, and see you next time.